Welcome to my YouTube channel, Lifestyle Tutorials. My tutorial today, I'll be taking you one-on-one on how to recover your KRA password. KRA is a body mandated to monitor collection of tax in the Kenyan government. So I'll be taking you one-on-one on the procedure of how to recover. So the first thing that we'll head to iTax, an online platform, where we are able to access Kenya Revenue Authority's services from online. So here what happens is, in case we enter our user ID or like KRA PIN, and we don't have, that is in case we want to recover our password, the first thing that we'll do, we'll click is we will come here and forget password. So we'll come here and say, and fill this security stamp, which is 123 plus 1 is 124. Our 124, then we'll be able to see forgot password. It will take us to this area where it tell us user ID, is this security stamp. We'll have to put that security stamp of 889. Then we'll be able to submit. Once we submit, it tells us your password has been emailed to you. We'll come to our email address. KRA never gets it wrong. We'll refresh our browser. Once we refresh our browser, I'm sure we'll be able to get the password. This is the password that has been sent. We'll be able to open it. Password reset KRA web portal. So this is the password that we've just been given. We'll be able to type it one-on-one to the browser so that we may continue in the whole process of recovery of password. So it tells us the password has been mailed it to you. We'll come here and fill our user ID. So in the process of recovering the password, we'll be able to fill the password. As you can see, it has an X. Then we fill the security stamp and say login. Once we come here, we'll be able to tell it not to save. We'll come here, it tells us to put our old password. We put the new password, then we continue to our security question. At that point, we'll fill our old password, then the new password, then we confirm the password. We'll go to our security question. It will be able to choose a very easy question, a question that we can never forget, like in what city were you born? Then we'll be able to fill the security question, the city someone was born. Then we'll say confirm the security question, the security answer. We'll be able to confirm it again. Then it tells us KRA website policy disclaimer. Kenya Revenue Authority here in after referred to as referred to as KRA website policy disclaimer governs the matter in its website www.kra. Herein referred that the ordered and received all the products or services offered by KRA. We'll have to agree with the terms. Then we'll see here that it tells us this is a password policy. The password should be a minimum of 4 letters, maximum of 50 letters. Password should not be repeated. It should not repeat. So once you put one password, it should never be repeated. Another rule of law is that password length is less than 4 characters. That is for a short one. So we need to put at least a strong password, which is at least eight characters, contains combination of the digital uppercase and lowercase and special characters. This one we've been able to put a password that is at least sane fair, which at least falls under this category. So guideline for the security policy, it says that the password length should be minimum of eight letters. It should be have upper and lowercase. It should have special letters. And it should be in words or language, slang or direct or jargon. Those are the policies to make it. So we'll be able to click that I've read the policies, and we'll proceed to submit. So we'll be able to click submit and tells me please enter the old password collection. So we'll be able to come and enter the old password collection.